Alright, welcome back to another web development video where I show you how to make modern websites using HTML5, CSS3, and a little bit of JavaScript. In this video, we're going to head back into Webflow and look at some more unique animations that we can do through the Interactions tab. So we have sort of a basic website here. It's a nice hero image and text, and then there's this grid of images here, and then a little bit more text. So what we're going to do is we're going to animate some of these, specifically the images here and the large header image. We're going to animate these as we scroll down the page. So when we come into our Interactions tab, normally you're looking at things in the Styles tab. But the interactions are the little lightning bolt. And in previous videos, we've used the element trigger so that when this particular element or a section hits the viewport on scroll, then it does something. This time we're just going to look at the entire window, or the entire body. It's actually the body of the page, so from the top to the bottom of the page, however much space that takes up. That's what we're looking at today, and that's in our page triggers. So if we click to add one, we can do things when the page loads, or when the mouse enters the viewport, or when the page is scrolled generally, or we can do things while the page is scrolling, and this is sort of a continuous interaction. So not just when you scroll the page, but as you continue scrolling down the page, things are continuously happening. So that's the one that we want to use for this particular set of animations. And then on scroll, we need to select some sort of action. So we're going to play a scroll animation, and we'll talk about smoothing in a minute, but we don't have any animations to play yet. So let's go ahead and add an animation. This is going to be called fun scrolling animation. I don't know, it should be more descriptive than that, but that's not what we're gonna do. The first thing I want to do is I want to take this image, and as we scroll down the page, I want it to gradually fade out so that we're just left with the text here. So we're going to click on, we can do the image itself, or we could hide this entire section. Let's just click on the actual image. You can see we are in this image here. Here's the structure of everything we have. We have this section here with the hero. There's a container sort of giving us this maximum width, and then there's an image inside that. The second section is a paragraph, same thing. There's a container with a paragraph in it. The third section is this grid. It's a full section that has a CSS grid in it, and then each of our images is taking up one column. And then our last section is sort of a duplicate of this with the max width container and then the paragraph inside of it. So that's how the document is structured. So let's click on our image, and at 0%, so at the very top of the page, as the user starts to scroll, we want to do opacity. Now this is a little boring. Our opacity is just going to be 100%. So as soon as the user hits the page, we want that to be 100%. But as soon as they start scrolling, we want it to do something. So by the time the user gets to the very bottom, remember the 100% here is talking about the very bottom of the page. So I'll show you what happens if we just leave it at 100%. You're not going to see very much. So we're starting at 100%, and we want our ending animation to be 0. We want that to be 0% for opacity. Ease in, ease out is fine with me. And let's take a look at that in the page. So remember, we're scrolling the entire page, and things are happening while we're scrolling. Now you can see that it is changing color. You see how that's a little bit lighter on the sides, and you can see even the opacity happening right there. Now we're not going to see the image go to 0, because by the time we get down to the bottom of the page, we can't see it anymore. It's not there. The reason is that we chose 100% for the ending of our animation, and that's not where we want it to end. We actually want, by the time the user scrolls probably 10 or 15%, that's when we want it to go to opacity of 0, because it's not looking at the viewport size for 100%, it's looking at the entire size of the body element, or the HTML element on the page. So, sort of a catch, something you have to kind of figure out. So let's set it at 15. So at 0%, when we start scrolling, it's going to be 100% opacity, which is full opacity. And then at 15% of the height of the page, it's going to go to 0%. So let's see if that gives us what we're looking for. So as we scroll down the page, you can see that now we're starting to get our opacity. Now, we really want it to, I'd like it to sort of match up to where it fades out about right there. So that just means that we need to adjust what percentage of the page that we wind up with the opacity. So as we scroll down, that's a little bit more of what I wanted. And could even go as much as 20. So let's do 20. And that's gonna get us pretty close to what I was envisioning. So as you get here, that distraction is gone, and now we're right into the text. But you can see on the scroll, that's what's happening. Okay, and the next interaction that I want to do is this grid here. What I want this grid to do is to go to start way over here, and then as the user comes down, there's going to be a blank space here. And so as they scroll down to about here, I want these images to start coming in. And by the time you get to here, you can see all four images. And as you scroll down, you know, now you're left with the next section of text. So that's what we're looking at now. We want to make sure that we select the grid. I want the section to just stay, so I want to grab all the elements inside the section. And this one is going to be a little trickier, so I'm just going to make a guess here. You know, how far down the page am I? You can look over here at your scroll bar, and that's going to be about 50%. So at about 50% or so, we want this to start moving. And then by the time we get to, I don't know, 60%, 65%, we want it to be fully into the page. So you can sort of gauge that by looking at your scroll bar over here and seeing, you know, what is what percentage are we on the page, because you can see the full page here, and what percentage is your scroll bar. So that's a little tip, a little trick. So we'll start it at, I don't know, maybe 40%. So we come in and we set at 40%. We're gonna set a move, okay? And so we want to move the grid. We want to start the grid at 100%. So this is one thing, nope, not 10%, but 100%. This is something I've learned over the years doing animations for like menus, bringing slide-in menus back into the page when you click on a hamburger menu icon. If you push the element to the right, this is basically transforming the element in CSS. So if you push it to the right 100%, that takes the whatever the width of the element is and pushes it 100%. So it's literally right off of the page over here. And then when you bring it back, which we're going to do at, say, let's say 60%, we want to make another move to the grid, and we want that to come back in at 0. Okay, so 0 is where it's originally placed in the HTML and your original CSS for the element. The 100% pushes it to the right 100%. If you wanted to do from the left, then you would simply do a minus 100%. You can see that the grid is over here now. You can see a little bit sticking out right here, that it's poking a little bit. So I want it to come in from the right to the left across the page this way. And when we get to 40% of the page, if we do our live preview, so when we get to 40%, you can see that we haven't quite gotten to that section yet, and it's already starting to come in. So by the time we get to 60, this is in the center of the page. That's all a little bit later. That's a little bit earlier than I want it to happen. I want it to happen just a touch later. So if we do live preview, we come down, you can see that that was where I wanted to start it. I wanted to start it right around here. So you're reading. All of a sudden you're still reading, and then this is starting to come in. And by the time you reach this part where this might be in your field of vision, so let's say I'm still reading through here, by the time I get to this part here, you know, I can see these images. They all come in, and then I can continue reading down the page. So when you come up the page, the cool part about these scroll events is that they happen the same way. So they're happening every time that you scroll. So interesting thing that's going on. So our opacity comes back into full. So when we look at it here, we can get the full effect. And so you can see as the user scrolls down the page, now this text starts to highlight itself. And as we finish up this paragraph here, we have these images coming in. And then we can look at all the images. If you had a really long strip here, they could just keep coming. And then we get down to our bottom text. And same thing happens on the way back up. So this is creating what we call a while the page is scrolling animation. So it's a page trigger animation, and it's while the page is scrolling, these things are continuously happening. If you were using on the page scrolled, so that would mean the animation would sort of start and stop. So if you had done this animation with the page scrolled trigger, as you finished scrolling down the page, this would probably just still be it would still be opacity of zero when you scroll back up. Okay, so that's what happened on a previous animation video where we brought in the blog header images, I guess, in our blog. They sort of moved up and faded in. But as soon as you started going back up the page and you did it again, they didn't do it. It was like a one-time sort of shot. They didn't reset themselves. But here, everything is resetting itself because we're using a different trigger here for our animation. So while the page is scrolling. Okay, and the last part is smoothing. So by definition, from Webflow, smoothing is how quickly the animation responds to the scroll movement. So it's almost like a little bit of a delay. It doesn't happen. You're scrolling and it's moving a little bit slower than when you scrolled. And what this does is it gives the illusion that it's a little bit smoother. So let's try a couple of different settings. Let's see the extremes. So 0% results in an instant jump when the interaction stops triggering. So this is going to be a real jumpy sort of scroll. So it's going to be kind of a jumpy scroll. Basically every move that the scroll makes, it's jumping for that scroll. Okay. And let's try 50%. Actually, let's do it at 100%. And then we can see what the full smoothing looks like. So you can see the animation is not even starting. You see how long it takes to do that animation. It's sort of like when you're doing a transition and you're determining how long does it take for that transition to happen. So this would be a really long transition. Now it's still happening, but it's happening way, way slower. Okay, so that's super smooth. You can see it takes forever for it to come back to 100%. Same thing here. It should have already been coming into the page at that point, but there's a real delay. So that even when I stop scrolling, it's still moving. It's just taking a long time to get in there. And same thing, I've only gone down one notch, but it's taken a really long time for it to get in there. So that's not exactly what I was looking for. I wanted it to be a little bit more responsive than that, so that by the time I get here, you know, all these things are already in there. So 100% is a little bit slow for me. So their suggestion is 50. I'm going to go with 60 and just see how that looks. So as we scroll down, so this is going to be a little less responsive than the default. It's way more responsive than the 100 and a little bit less responsive than, because you can see, I don't know if you can see the delay. There's not much of a delay. It almost happens in real time, but it's still smooth. You see that? So when I stop, it doesn't continue to move. So it's happening in real time. If you were on a tablet or a phone, these animations would be smoother. You can get a smoother animation by using the bar over here. But when you use the mouse wheel, it jumps a certain amount of distance with each scroll of the mouse wheel. And so it's not quite as smooth as if you were looking on a phone. Okay. So that is basically how to do, how to use the while the page is scrolling animation. You could do this with any element. You can move them forward, backward, to the left, to the right, up and down, however you want to move them. And you can create some really interesting things. One of the initial things I did was to fade this out and then fade this in. So if you wanted to do that, you come into your scrolling animation, and once the image, which probably started at about 15, then we want to do an opacity for this paragraph. And let's just set it to ease. And we want to start it at 0% opacity. So it's totally, totally not there. But as this begins to fade out, in fact, let's put it at like 10%. And then we want to, by the time we get to 20%, we want that to be at a full opacity. That's not the one that we want. We want the paragraph, right? So by the time the paragraph gets to 20%, we want that to be 100% opacity. So let's see how that works up here. So as we're scrolling down, this is fading out and the text is fading in. You see how that works? So you can sort of fade different elements out. No one's ever going to know that this is 0% opacity down here, because on page load, that's what you're going to see. So as this fades out, then our text fades in, and this comes in here, and then our text is still there. So, and as we go up, our text fades out again. So you see how that works. So that's some really cool things. Your imagination is really the only limitation as to what you can do with these different actions. You can combine, I believe, these actions together, the interactions. You can combine them together where you're doing some page triggers, you're doing some element triggers. And so you can sort of mix and match and create some really compelling types of animations with the page scroll. Hopefully this is helpful to you. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments section below. I'll get to them as best I can. When there aren't many comments, I take that as I did a great job explaining. So hopefully that's what happens. But if you do have any troubles, or if I said something wrong, please feel free to correct me down in the comments section below. And remember to hit the thumbs up on the video. It really helps to be able to spread things farther and help more people. Also, if you feel like sharing the video, that would be awesome. Sharing it with your social media network. And If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and click the bell notification. So when you click the bell notification, then you can receive notifications when new videos come. Usually one or two a week is how many I release. And go check out Webflow. If you haven't signed up for a free account, there's a link down in the description. You can just click that link and go straight to Webflow and sign up for a free account. You get a couple of projects that you can use for free. And if you decide that you want to keep using it and go on and actually publish a website with your own URL, you can do that through Webflow, and you just have to pay for their hosting account. All right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next time.